to Studio 5. We're turning now to a topic that, let's just face it, men would rather not talk about, from going to counseling to going to the doctor, whatever help they may be needing or you may be seeking in your relationship. Sometimes it's hard to convince the guys that's a necessary ask.
There's the problem, is because you think we need it, we don't necessarily always think we need it. So how do we figure this out? We get Studio 5 relationship coach Matt Townsend to come in and help us out here.
That is funny.
Isn't that sort of part of the challenge?
Totally.
Yeah.
What would a man need?
We don't need anything.
We got everything we need. If we needed something, we'd go get it.
We'd take care of it.
Right. Like a mommy pooch. What
Matt
man doesn't have a mommy
fun of
pooch?
That phrase.
And we're not even mommies, and we don't even use the word pooch.
So here's my question. You see couples every day, week after week.
Yes.
How often is it the woman that's maybe suggesting or dragging her man through the door?
Always.
Okay.
It's not always, but a lot, I mean, it's higher. And remember, women, 70% of divorces are filed by women. Okay? And usually when the men come in, they're like, what? What's the big deal?
You've sort of said this before. Men get blindsided
by
it, right?
It's like a total surprise. Now, one reason is because we're not necessarily reading the relational cues as well. We probably don't even know what they are. Women tend to read the cues more. But as far as getting help, the male ego, men have ego. I don't know if you've heard this.
Really?
But yeah, we do. But this ego is a big deal, and we need it, because if I'm supposed
it's
to go,
important.
If I'm supposed to kill
thing.
A bear, I need some ego. If I went just on intellect, I'd be like, no, that thing could kill me. But my ego says, no, try. What's the worst thing that
was
could
that
happen?
On your weekend to-do list from Marty?
Oh, yeah.
Kill a bear?
I killed a bear and two gazelles. It was a weird day. Draper's got some weird wildlife. But one of the problems is our ego gets involved. And so remember, men know our identity doesn't come from who we are. Traditionally, our identity comes from what we do. So to go and do something that makes us seem weak, like to go to a doctor and get an exam, it's not what we want to do. We'd rather pretend like we don't need the exam, right? And then until it festers and you get pneumonia, stuff like that. So
not that you're speaking from personal experience or anything.
So one of the things we want to do is we want to understand that men would rather fix it themselves. So if you want to get your man to go fix something, you've got to know their natural psyche is to do it themselves. So you can keep trying to go say, there's a bunch of people that can help us with this, but inherently they're going to not do that. That's why men don't pull over and ask for directions. Who's going to tell me where I need to be? I'm driving. I know I'm lost. I'll figure it out. So one of the keys is with this is you've got to understand my thinking is first let me try it. So maybe create some conversations with us where you let us try to do it our way with the caveat that if it doesn't work out, then we'll go get some help.
So is part of the scare of counseling, therapy, coaching, something like that, is part of the scare that men don't like to talk? Because we've talked about,
huge.
You mentioned action.
That's exactly
I mean, men
right.
kind of bond
so
in
men
action.
Don't tend to bond talking.
Right.
Statistically, women are more inclined to bond talking. So therapy, for example, is pure conversation in our head.
That's the worst thing in the world.
That's
right
exactly
here.
Right.
We're asking for someone
right.
for help, and they want to make
right.
us talk.
And they want. And so why would we talk? Why don't we just fix it? What is it you want? You want me to clean more? I'll clean more. Shut it. I'll clean. I'll clean. We don't need to go anywhere. Let's just do something. So we tend to be afraid a little bit of the communication, having to talk about it. Part of it's too, because it's kind of unknown to us.
Mm-hmm.
We don't necessarily always feel good after talking. We would feel good after talking if it was creating and driven towards solution. So one of the goals is make sure that if you're getting help, that it tends to be solution oriented. You could drive your counselor or ask your counselor, can you make sure that we get some solutions and that we can go home and practice stuff? Instead of just talking in the session, maybe make sure you can also go home and have something to do. I would also turn the event itself into an action. We're going to go to dinner. We're going to have fun. We're going to go to the therapist. Then we're going to come back and we're going to implement what we learned. So it's a full act.
You know, I often think of that. When I'm going to listen to anyone speak or talk, whether it's in church or some convention or something like that, if someone gives me something concrete to do, I feel like it's been time worthwhile.
That's exactly
if
right.
it's just a conversation,
uh-huh.
then I feel like that
yeah.
was a total waste.
No, I sat there with a couple and I made them do an activity without me. They were just doing it in a session with me. And the husband was like, "Okay, let's get on, let's get on, let's get on, let's get on with it."
Yeah.
But he didn't realize that we were actually coming up with solutions that he was then going to go home and implement. He didn't like having to just sit there and do an activity without knowing specifically that's going to be an activity we're going to go home
an
and do.
An action plan.
A real action. Third thing, remember that men tend to come from our left brain. So we like the left brain, very data-oriented, very analytical. So you need to approach your partner if you want them to go get help from their left brain. You might want to show them, look, if you do have a sickness and you don't go get that colonoscopy, it's going to cost us this, this is going to happen, and start giving data, very real-life things that will impact their life. Do you want to have this happen to you? Do you want to have to do this? Do you want to have to, and try to get them thinking from their left brain. Use words like patterns, solutions, skills, principles, tools. One of the things I do, one of the reasons date nights works with my program is because it's an action that when they go there, I can actually, we make it fun so they don't know they're being, they don't know they're having an intervention. And we approach them from the left brain. I use words that are kind of manly.
So you don't say emotions, feelings.
Feelings. And so the idea of going to talk about feelings with a third party, seriously, not a good idea.
That's frightening right there.
And the reality is men need that too. So what we do is we're going to go and we're going to talk and learn how to build some solutions and stop these patterns that don't work so that you and then show us how we're going to benefit. Hmm. What's the resolution that's going to come out of it? It's hard. Men are complicated. But you know what? There's one more tool.
No, men are simple. Men are the simple ones.
It really is. Okay. It really is.
Depends on who's
quit
thinking
trying to be patronizing
it.
To the women who are watching. We are the simple people right
we
here.
We are. You're so complicated. We're sick of it.
I'm in trouble.
The last thing is it's got
to be used as a weapon. Of all the women
it's got
to
be the guy's choice. See, the hard part is whoever has the most energy, which tends to be the female on us getting help, that energy is what's driving all of this. If your man doesn't have that energy, then I won't make that choice. It's still got to be my choice. So one of the things you might want to do is say, honey, how could we ever fix it? Because, man, I'd love to give you advice. Men like to give advice because it's moving towards solution.
Right.
So you might say, honey, we don't seem to talk or communicate very well. What are some things we could do to improve our communication? He'll give you a list. So he's got ideas. Well, no, he'll never say, let's go see a therapist. But we could read a book. We could do this. We could do this. You could add a few others. We could go to our pastor, or we could go to a date night, or we could go to whatever. Then what you got to say is, great, honey, out of those six, what are a couple you'd be willing to try this week? And then let him choose off of his own list. So invite him to come up with solutions, which we'll be brilliant at. Then make him choose a couple off of his list.
And if it works, good. And if it doesn't work, then you go back to the list.
That's right.
But don't think like it has to be your list.
No. If it's your list, odds are it won't work.
Yeah.
Because guys need to own it. And the best way to own it is to let us be involved in it. It sounds so weird, but if you want us to get help, you need to make it seem like it was our idea.
Kind of that reverse.
And the funny thing is that sounds bad, but I know women out there are smart enough to do that. You're doing that all day long. Let's be real. You just pretend like we have power.
Got it.
And speaking of tricking them into it.
Got it.
You have opportunities to do that.
This
right?
is a great date night. This is date night January 13th. It's now going to be at the Miller campus in Salt Lake, in where is that? Like Draper, South Georgia,
yeah.
Sandy. But call us Matt Townsend, www.matttownsend.com or 747-2121. This date night is on our differences. So if you and your partner want to start having a conversation about our differences, how to communicate better, get to that date night. $35. Tons of fun.
And it's genius what you're doing because it complements this whole discussion that you're getting men there in a situation that's fun, it's action oriented.
They won't even know it.
They won't even know.
Until we start the testing.
They like it, they come together. Thanks,
Love
Matt.
Thanks,
we'll be
kids.
Back with more in Studio 5 after this.